A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 31st July, on the front page you have Coffee Day Siddhartha goes missing. So this is regarding VG Siddhartha, founder of the iconic Cafe Coffee Day chain. He went missing from a bridge across Netravati River in Mangaluru in Karnataka, and his body has now been recovered. He has been declared dead. So a massive search was initiated to trace the entrepreneur. And it is said that he has written a letter purportedly written by Vijay Siddhartha that surfaced hours after he went missing, blamed harassment from income tax authorities for his situation. And also he had debt. So there are these issues which are rising. Then next is protests over Unnao accident rocks Lok Sabha. So BJP says don't politicize the issue. So we have seen about this. BJP MLA Kuldeep Sengar had raped her in 2017, and this Unnao rape survivor, she was her uncle who had initiated the case, also had been charged in another case and was in jail. And the rape victim, along with her survivors, along with her relatives, was going to visit her when she met with an accident, which has resulted in her situation being critical. She's critically injured in a car crash. So this. And even the case against the uncle had been registered by the BJP MLA Sengar, who was allegedly raped her. Then below you have Triple Talaq Bill sails through Rajya Sabha. So the Triple Talaq Bill has been passed in Rajya Sabha as well. So we have seen about this bill. 240 member Rajya Sabha saw 90 members voting in favor of the bill. And this is government did not try out GST system before rollout. So this is what the Comptroller and Auditor General of India is saying. This is the first ever audit of the GST. So it says government had failed to try out the system before its rollout, leading to inadequate compliance mechanisms and lower tax revenue. So this is a report tabled in the House now, in the Parliament. Then this is Truecaller bug sparks fear of hacking. So several Android phone users who have installed Truecaller app were in for a shock yesterday when they received text messages saying their registration for UPI app, Unified Payment Interface app, has started and their bank account was linked to ICICI Bank portal for UPI transactions. So this became a cause of concern about the Truecaller bug. Then on page 7 you have this, this is called the village of books. It's the first village of books in India. It's called Pustakanche Gaon in Marathi. It is in Bhilar village in Satara district in Maharashtra. So it is inspired by the Hay on Wey, a town in Wales known for its bookstores and literature festivals. So this Pustakanche Gaon, village of books, was set up on May 4, 2017, as many as 30 villagers offer space at their residence for the large variety of books. So this is the reader coming and reading. And this is a 78-year-old lady who is blowing air to burn charcoal to protect books from fungus and stiffness during the rains. Then on page 8, you have Yediyurappa government scraps Tipu Jayanti. So the new government has been formed in Karnataka, and you can see some of the first steps which it took. It has called off birth anniversary celebrations of Tipu Sultan, the 18th century king of Mysuru. So it had been a government sponsored annual event since 2015 by the Congress regime. So Tipu Sultan had fought against the Britishers. He died in the war, but BJP calls him a tyrant and anti-Hindu ruler. Below you have efforts on to help Vembanad Lake breathe. So this is plastic bottles, which are the most prevalent form of pollution in the Vembanad Lake, which is a designated Ramsar site and one of the most polluted water bodies in the world. And it is plastic waste which is a cause of concern. So a group of fishermen have been conducting plastic collection drives every year since 2011. This is Vembanad Lake. In Kerala. And the blame for the menace is squarely put on operators of houseboats plying in the backwaters. And this is hidden chenchus and crouching tigers. So blending into natural habitat, chenchus help conserve tigers in Nallamala. So this is regarding chenchus, which are members of particularly vulnerable tribal groups, PVTGs. So you can see they toil all day in the expansive Nallamala forests, and they help in conserving the tigers in Andhra Pradesh. The number of tigers in Andhra Pradesh has been put up as 48 by the National Tiger Conservation Authority. On page 9, you have too much quota may impact right to equal opportunity, Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court has said that reservation is intended to achieve equality of opportunity. Reservation itself is an exception. Reservation is, you cannot give quota benefits to the most forward classes, especially to those who had no qualification whatsoever. Then this would result in excess reservation and breach of equality. So this is what the Supreme Court has orally remarked on excessive quota being provided. So quota should be an exception. So this is in the context of even the 10% economic quota which the central government has provided in jobs and educational institutions for economically weaker sections. Then this is insurance scheme for cattle lost to tigers mooted. So the Union Environment Ministry is exploring a scheme to devise an insurance policy that will compensate people who lose their livestock to tigers. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Burning Bright. So this is regarding the tiger census. So it says peer review and scientific publication can make India's tiger census a global model. So this was the front page news yesterday too. And this is flea market. So this is regarding how investors seem to be disappointed with tax measures seen as burdening businesses. So we have seen high income group have been taxed, which affects the foreign portfolio investors. So this is discussed here. That was a tax announced in the budget. Then this is padding up for the next UN Security Council innings. So India has become one of the members of Indian United Nations Security Council for a 2-year term. So it says India must give exceptional weightage to how all Security Council issues have an impact on the subcontinent. So this is article in that context. And this is the makings of a digital kleptocracy. So it says when data is monetized, as the economic survey advocates, it becomes toxic and harms public interest. So this is one issue which is discussed here. Even how right to information has been diluted is mentioned. On op-ed page, you have focusing on the critical years of a child's life. So this says what the draft national education policy omits in its chapter on early childhood care and education is focusing on the critical years, the initial years, you can see, from age 1 to 3 before school education begins. So this is called the Orisha model. It says other states could take a cue from Orisha, which has empowered women politically and financially. So representation of women MPs in 17th Lok Sabha has been an improvement from 11% in 2014 to 14% in 2019, but it is still lower than global average of 24.3%. So this is regarding Orisha here. 1/3 of the seats in Lok Sabha election. You can see Orisha Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik nominated women for 1/3 of the seats in Lok Sabha election. So that is a good initiative. Self-help groups work well here. So they are empowered politically and economically. On page 13, you have rules flouted in GST fund transfer. So Comptroller and Auditor General of India has submitted its report in Parliament, as we saw on the front page, and it has flagged violations in transferring the integrated GST amounts to states. That is a cause of concern. On international page, you have make a deal now or you may not get one, Trump tells China. So now he has warned Beijing against waiting out his term as trade talks resumed in Shanghai. So the 2020 presidential elections would take place in USA. So this is a warning which President Trump has given to China. And this is China bets big on 5G technology. So China is spending $150 billion on the technology in 6 years. On business page, you have this details regarding Cafe Coffee Day, the founder who has been found dead now. On page 17, you have end use norms for external commercial borrowings eased. So relaxation for working capital and general corporate purposes have been announced by RBI. So end use of funds raised via external commercial borrowings route by companies and non-banking finance companies have been eased now. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, ashr.com. I'm sorry, I've not been able to cope with the current affairs coverage in the PDF format and in the full-fledged video for the students who have enrolled for the course. There has been an issue. We have a family member admitted in ICU, and it is a difficult time. So I've not been able to cope with it, and I'm sorry. Thank you.